Well, good morning, folks, and it's another glorious sunny day in September. And you join us on our next MMD road trip. Last time we went north to Yorkshire Dales. This time we're going south to
Dorset.
And
Dorset.
This time we're going south to
Dorset
and Devon, and hopefully taking some of the Jurassic Coast. So we'll catch you later on the road. Roll the intro. Our route was going to be about 6 days, taking in some of the delights of Dorset and Devon, starting off in Bath, then staying our second night in Shaftesbury, then followed by a little village of Beer on the south coast before heading up to the north coast of Devon, staying at the Blue Ball Inn, heading back to Shepton Mallet before eventually ending up in Castle Coombe. But our first stop was the delightful city of Bath, or if you're from the south, Bath. Bath is the largest city in Somerset, and it's known for and named after its Roman built baths. It's Britain's only natural thermal spa and was named a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It also has more museums in a square mile than any other English city. But we weren't here to enjoy the cultural delights of Bath. It was basically a stopover and a springboard into our trip through Dorset and Devon. Our accommodation in Bath was going to be a B&B, albeit a boutique B&B, a Victorian house built in 1874 that's been refurbished recently. The only downside was it was up a hill and it was about, you know, 15 minutes walk from the centre of town. So here we are, folks, Bath. What a beautiful day for it too. And we just checked into our little B&B, our little boutique B&B, the Tendal. And it's quite a nice place, actually. It's obviously been refurbished very recently. So I want to go in and take a look around. 10 at the Tyndall Boutique Villa. Very clean. It's quite small, isn't it? But it's clean.
It's small, but it's been newly decorated, so it's really lovely. It's clean, and I guess that's what you want on this day and age, isn't it? Functional, good shower.
Yeah, good shower, good clean bathroom.
Lots of plugs.
Yes, and lots of plugs to charge everything. As you can see, every plug is being used. iPads, laptops, GoPros. Yeah. Oh, very pleasant. Having googled the local eateries, we're headed down the hill for a 15-minute walk into town. So we found an eatery called Dre's, which does ribs. Luckily, we found a place that sold ribs and craft beer. How perfect was that? And frankly,
this is what caught your eye, man.
And craft beers. Result, we're in. Sadly, in this place, to get served, you had to download an app and order it through the app, out sitting outside, which proved very problematical and the signal wasn't good. So we gave up on it and headed downstairs to Gourmet Burger Kitchen. Gourmet Burger Kitchen. Another burger? Call me old-fashioned, but those are proper chips. Skinny fries? What's all that? Proper chips? Look at that. Is that supposed to be
skinny fries?
The anorexic fries. Rubbish, that is. We found a pub called the Westgate, and while I was off ordering beers, Sue was introduced to the safety officer, who was explaining to her how to use the toilet. I was fascinated by this, so I asked if I could interview her for the channel, but unfortunately she declined.
Do you use the toilet? Do you use your elbow? The cage? And then... Thank you.
We end up here at Brown's for a nightcap. Of Jaipur IPA and the finest Pinot Grigio you can get in Bath.
It's just a house white. I'm not difficult.
And so after a good night, we staggered back up the hill to the B&B. Funnily, it seems to take a lot longer to get back.
Good way to start the day.
Well, good morning, folk. Today it's going to be a really hot day, up to 26 to 28, I think, down this part of the world. And we're off to Cheddar Gorge and then Glastonbury for a coffee before finally ending up at our accommodation for tonight in Shaftesbury.
If you're ever staying in Bath, the Tyndall Villa would be a good option, as long as you don't mind the kind of long walk down the hill and then even longer walk back up the hill. Cheddar Gorge is a limestone gorge in the Mendip Hills near the village of Cheddar in Somerset. The gorge is the site of the Cheddar Show Caves, where Britain's oldest complete human skeleton, Cheddar Man, estimated to be 9,000 years old, was found in 1903. So, this is Glastonbury, folks. Self-proclaimed quirkiest town in England. Steeped in history, myth, and the smell of incense. Glastonbury Tor is a tower-topped hill linked to King Arthur. And it's said that King Arthur's burial place is actually in the old Glastonbury Abbey. But obviously, in latter years, its biggest claim to fame is the Glastonbury Festival, the largest greenfield music and performing arts festival in the world. Don't you just love motorcycle parking bays? Anyway, back secure, it was time to wander off and explore the magic of Glastonbury. We are in Glastonbury, folks, on a steaming hot day. You can tell it's Glastonbury.
Being back in Sedona, yeah. All those psychic shops.
I can smell
joss sticks.
Yes, incense sticks for the youngsters of today. My idea was a joss stick. Let's go find a coffee somewhere. Fantasy art shops. Crystals. They've got everything here. They've even got a speaking tree. Tantric sensual awakening. No, we haven't got time for that. Wait a minute. No, no time for sensual awakenings today. £4,000 amethyst. Look at this. What a great bookshop. However, I'm looking for a specific book called Riding by the Seat of My Pants. It's not in here.
Is the right genre, darling. Mine, however.
Yeah. Because when Sue's bestseller is being released. When's it being released?
It should be September.
September.
Marcus Crane, One More Lifetime.
Yeah. So that will be in the books. Coming soon for Christmas.
With a great bike ride in it.
Yeah, it does sort of have a Pan American ride.
Amazing.
Because they haven't got smell vision on this. Mm. Wow.
It smells amazing.
I think that's been gone every legal drug known to man.
Thank you.
At over 750 feet above sea level, Shaftesbury is one of the highest towns in England. The Saxons built a hilltop settlement here because of its commanding position. And King Alfred the Great founded an abbey here, which became a popular destination for pilgrims during the medieval period. Perhaps it's most famous for being the home of Gold Hill, where the iconic Hovis advert was filmed in 1973 by director Ridley Scott. But more of that later. Our accommodation in Shaftesbury was 3 Ivy Cross, another B&B, but first we had to negotiate the deep gravel driveway. B&B in Shaftesbury. It's quite a nice place to have a look at it. There we are, lovely. Nice, bright, spacious, cool. Got a Dyson cooling fan because it's about 28 degrees at the moment. A nice, fresh, clean bathroom. Looks like it's been refurbished. Almost like a wet room. Great view, lovely garden down there. So let's go down and take a look at the garden as well.
I want to meet the great hound.
This is lovely.
Beautiful
view. Lovely gardens.
Supplies. Supplies from the local shop. What have you got?
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat?
For you, for later.
Little Milton.
Well, there we are, folks, in the delightful little town of Shaftesbury. One of the highest towns in Britain, apparently. Certainly drove up some steep hills to get here. We're just scoping out where we're going to get a beer tonight and where we're going to eat. And this looks like a likely place. The Mitre.
Right, let's go and check out. We'd have to book it out.
Put a mask on.
Time. 2:25, which is persuading me to have a beer. Proper job. In the afternoon. Against my better judgment, Sue forced me to drink a pint of proper job in the afternoon.
Thank you.
This is lovely.
Drinking beer this time of
year. I'm thirsty, darling. We're on holiday.
Thirsty?
I'm thirsty.
Warning, the following clip contains scenes of a nostalgic nature. If you're under 50, you probably will understand.
Taking bread to the top of the world. 'Twas a grand ride your boy, he'd say. You must have gone up that hill as fast as you came down. Hovis.
So it's a big, long walk up Gold Hill, and right at the top of it, this is what you need, defibrillator. Right, time for our pre-dinner beer. So where are we going to go? We're going to go to the pub of the year, 2019, the Ship Inn.
Is the Ashton Press, is it a sweeter cider?
Yes, sweeter.
I'll have a pint of that, please. Thank you.
One of you could just fill in.
Can you fill up a pint?
Sure, yeah, no worries.
Let's get a
short wait. Which are your local brews?
Of ales.
Yes.
We've only got two on at the moment, and they're both quite local. This is
Moon
very local.
Oh, I'll try a pint of that, please, yeah. Moonlaw.
It's weird, see.
Moonlaw.
His daughter,
$7.90.
Cheers, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Pin. Pub of the year 2019. Yeah. To be honest, wouldn't get my vote. So now we're going to the Mitre, which serves a proper job on draft, which is fantastic. After King Alfred set up Shaftesbury Abbey in AD 888, he decided to branch out into the catering business and set up his own pastry shop, which he expanded throughout the medieval world before sadly burning his cakes. So here we are in our favourite pub in Shaftesbury, which is the Mitre. So, Cheers, babe. Proper job. And when the Queen Mother was in the local area, she liked nothing better than to pop in and pull herself a quick pint.
I went into Aldi and they had
that soup.
So I took photos of
the things you go with it.
Do you want this guy?
What do you reckon? Lamb shank.
Looking good.
It looks brilliant. Lamb shank and a bottle of Rioja. Perfect. So here it is.
Sweetheart.
This is the greyhound that doesn't like running.
Good morning.
So this is Mike, he owns the B&B.
Hi.
And this is Monty.
this is Monty.
It's the most important part of the B&B.
How long have you had this place, Mike?
6 years, man.
6 years?
Yeah.
And how has it been affected by what's going on with COVID-19 and stuff?
Well, we've only reopened when the government said, which was beginning of July, I think.
And we've restricted the numbers here now, so we're down from 3 rooms to 2, just so that it's safe for everybody, for ourselves and the guests as well.
So normally you have 3 rooms, but now you're just having 2 rooms.
Yeah, it just makes life a lot easier.
So basically it means it's made it even more exclusive.
In a way, yeah.
So folks, if you want an exclusive place to stay near Shaftesbury, this is the one, because it's perfectly located, a few minutes walk into town, and the rooms are magnificent.
Lovely. There he is.
Good morning.
Careful, darling. Yeah. Just be gentle, that's it.
Monty, the greyhound that doesn't like running. Excellent.
We really love this place, so if you're in Shaftesbury and you need somewhere with great food, great room, great people, and Monty the dog, it comes highly recommended.